Okay, hopefully your Saved Gifts View controller is ready to go. Now let's add the ability to manage a collection. If we look in the Objective-C project, we can see that the Saved Gifts View controller conforms to the UI Collection View Delegate, the Collection View Data Source, and the Collection View Delegate Flow Layout. So we'll want to add all three of those to the Swift file. Now let's take a look at the implementation. If we scroll down to where the data source methods are, we can see our familiar friends, number of items in section, and cell for item at index path. Cool, no surprises there. Let's switch back to the Swift project, add our protocols, and then implement those methods. I've got a mark here for the delegate and data source methods. And now we want to add collection view, number of items in section, and cell for item at index path. For number of items in section, we're just going to want to return the number of saved gifts. And oops, we're not really ready to implement cell for item at index path yet, because we haven't made our custom cell. So let's make our custom cell. Go ahead and add the gift cell class and have it inherit from collection view cell. Open up Storyboard and find the scene called My Collection. Inside the collection view, you'll see the gift cell. Now go ahead and drag an outlet from the GIF image view into the GIF cell class. And then also in the GIF cell class, we're going to need a function called configureForGIF. And this is where we'll set the GIF image. And now let's switch back to the Saved Gifts View controller. And of course, if we want to be able to see our GIF cell, we should give it a size. So let's go here to our mark for the collection view flow layout. And here we are, here's the method for size for item at index path. So the width of our cell is going to be approximately half the width of the collection view frame. But of course, this method expects us to return a size. And we're going to need a margin as well. So let's go up to the top of our class and create a constant to hold the margin. You'll want to make this cell margin a CG float so that it plays nicely with the CG size. And we incorporate it into our width, and then of course we'll want to return the size, and we should be good to go. So this ought to give us two columns of cells in our collection view. And let's not forget to implement cell for item at index path. So of course we'll want to dequeue a cell, we'll want to cast it to a GIF cell, we'll grab a GIF from the saved GIFs array, and we'll configure the cell for that GIF. Now, sometimes when I just want to see my cells before I have data to put in them, I'll make them a weird color so they stand out. So I just went into Storyboard and I made them this blue color. And just for testing purposes, I'm returning 5 here in number of items in section, and then I commented out these two lines in cell for item at index path. And then when I run the app, what I see is this. So I can see my collection view, and I can see my cells, and I can tell that they're spaced the way I want them. I can also see that this view is kind of blocking my collection. If you look in the Objective-C project, you'll notice that this view that has the pink squares is called the empty view, because it's the view that's meant to appear when the collection is empty. My collection isn't empty right now, so I'm going to go ahead and add an outlet for this empty view. And I'll add a line to view will appear, so that when the number of saved gifts does not equal 0, the empty view is hidden. Go ahead and add an outlet to Storyboard for the collection view, and then while we're here in View Will Appear, we can call reload data. And now you can move on to work on the preview view controller.